Thou hadest and more, Miranda. how is it that this lives in thy mind? What see thou else in the dark backward in the abysm of time? 12 years since, Miranda, 12 years since, thy father was Duke of Milan and the Prince of Power.
Sir, and not you, my father.
And thy mother was a piece of virtue. And she said thou was my daughter. And thy father was Duke of Milan, and his only heir and princess. No worse issues.
Pray the heavens, what foul play have you that we came from thence?
My brother and thy uncle called Antonio. I pray thee mark me that a brother should be so perfidious. He who next thyself of all the world I loved, and to him put the manager of my state. The government are cast unto my brother, and to my stage grew stranger. Be transported and wrap this deep studies. Thy false uncle, dost thou attend me?
Sir, most heedfully.
Suck my virtue out on it. Thou attendest not.
A good so I do.
I pray thee, mark me. I thus neglecting all worldly ends, all dedicated to the closest affection of my mind. This king of Naples, being an enemy to me and better, but harpers my brother's suit. One midnight, fated for the purpose, did Antonio open the gates of Milan. And in the dead of darkness, the ministers for the purpose had offended me and thy crying self.
And lack of pity, I'm remembering how I cried out them to cry it over again. It is a hint that brings my noise to it.
Hear a little further, and then I'll bring thee to the present business which is now upon us, without the which this story were most impertinent.
Wherefore did they not that I would destroy us?
Well demanded, wench. My tale provokes that question. So dear the love my people bore me. In few, they hurried us aboard a bark, bore us some leagues to sea, where they prepared a rotten carcass of a butt. Not rig, tackle, not sail, nor mast, the very rats instinctively acquitted. There they hoist us, to cry to the sea that roared at us, to sigh to the winds whose pity signing back again did us but loving run.
Alack, what trouble was our venture?
Oh, my children, thou was that could preserve me.
How came you ashore?
By providence divine, some food we had, some fresh water, that a noble Neapolitan Gonzalo, out of his charity, who then being appointed master to this design, did give us with fresh garments, linen stuffs, and necessaries, which have since steadied much, and so of his gentleness. Knowing I loved my books, he furnished me for mine own life and with volumes of supplies above my dukedom.
And I might ever see that man.
Now I arise. Sit still and hear the last of our sea sorrow. Here on this island we arrive, and here have I thy schoolmaster made thee more proper than most princesses can, that have more time for vainer hours and tutors not so careful.
Heavens, thank you for it. And now I pray you, sir, still to speak in my mind your reason for raising the sea storm.
No, thus far for, by accident most strange, most bountiful fortune. Now, my dear lady, have mine enemies brought to this shore. Here, see small questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. Tis a bit dull, miss. Give it way, and no doubt cannot choose. Come away, my servant, come. I am ready now, accomplish my errand.
I come to answer thy best pleasure, for you should fly to swim, to dive into the fire, to ride on the curved clouds, thy strong green gun, Aerial and your melancholy.
Hast thou, spirit, forborne to the point the tempest that bade thee?
To every altar. I board in the king's ship, now on the beak, now on the waves, the deck, in every cabin I've laid to meet. Sometimes I defy and burn in many places on the topmast. The yard of war spirit when I make is thinking and he's enjoying. Jones vitals, the precursors, are the dreadful thundercats more momentary than sight up running or not. The fire crack of the sulphurous roaring most mighty Neptune seems to besiege and make his bold waves tremble. And you dread his trident shake.
My brave spirit, who was so firm, so constant, that disquiet did not affect her reason.
Not a soul but felt to be with the man and played some tricks. All the marinas plunged into the fiery grove and quit the vessel, then on the fire with me. The king's son burdened, and with hair upstanding, they left free, not tearing with the first man to the point. Hail the victory!
that's my spirit. But was this nice shawl?
Yes, I'm my master.
But are they heirloom safe?
Not the hair perishes. On their sustained garments, not a blemish, but fresher than before. And as thou back me, in truth, I have dispersed them about the earth. The king's son have I landed by himself, whom I left calling in the air beside, and sitting, his armed in this sand.
Of the kingship, the mariners, say how thou hast disposed of the rest of the fleet.
Safely in the harbour is the kingship, in the deep nook. There she sits in the reed, and all under hatch of stone, you the charmed wish of her that I have left at sea. And for the rest of the fleet which I have dispersed, they are on the Mediterranean coast, thou safely place for me. Supposing they saw the kingship wrapped in his great person perish.
Arian, thy charge exactly is performed. But there is more work. What is the time of the day?
Past the mid-season?
At least 2 glasses. The time took 6, and now by your spoke must be spent most preciously.
Then what will? Since thou must give me pain, let me remember thee what thou hast promised, which is not yet performed with me.
How now, Moody? What is it thou canst demand?
My liberty!
Before the time be out no more!
I prithee, remember I have done thee worthy service, called thee no thy servant for that grudge and grumbling. It is promised to pay me every year.
Hast thou, spirit, forgotten from what a torment I did free thee?
No.
Thou liest, malignant thing! Hast thou forgot that foul witch Sycorax, who with age and envy was grown into a hoop? Hast thou forgot her?
No, sir.
This blue-eyed hag was hither brought in charge, and here was left by the sailors. Thou, my slave, as thou reportest it thyself, was then her servant. And for thou was a spirit too delicate to act her earthly and of our commands. Refusing her grand hest, she did confine thee, by help of her more potent ministers, and in her most unmitigable rage, into a cloven pine. Within which rift, imprisoned thou didst painfully remain 12 years. Within which space she died, and left thee there, where thou did bend thy growth as fast as mill will strike. And then was this island safe for the sun she did litter here, a freckled whelp hag born, not under with a human shape.
Yes, Caliban.
Dolphin, I say so, he that Caliban, whom now I keep in service. Thou best knowest what a torment I did find thee in. Thy groan did make wolves howl, and penetrate the breast of every angry bears. It was a torment to lay upon the dams, which Sycorax could not again undo. It was mine art when I arrived, that heard thee, and mitigate the pain, and let thee out.
I think that I heard thee, master.
Thou more murmurest. I'll rend an oak, and peg thee in his nutty entrails till thou hast hard away 12 winters.
I will be correspondent to thy command, and do thy spirit gently.
Do so, and after 2 days I will discharge thee.
Say, where shall I go? Say, what shall I do?
Go, make thyself like a nymph of the sea. Be subject to no sight but thine and mine, invisible to every eyeball else. Go, take the shape, and never come into it. Go ahead with diligence. Awake, dear heart, awake. Thou hast slept well, awake.
The strangeness of your story has put heaviness in me.
Come on, shake it off. We'll bring this Caliban, my slave. He never yields us kind answer.
Tis a villain, sir, I do not love to look on.
But as tis, we cannot miss him. He does make our fire, put it on wood, and serves in offices that profit us. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Thou speak!
There's wood enough within!
Come forth, I say! Thou best answer other business! Come, thou tortoise when! Thou more poisonous slave! Not by the devil himself upon thy wicked dam! Come forth!
As wicked dew as ever my mother brushed with raven's feather from unwholesome fen, drop on you both. The southwest blowing ye and blistering ye all over.
For this, be sure tonight thou shalt have cramps, sack stitches that shall pen thy breath up. Urges shall that fast of night that they may work all exercise on thee. Thou shalt be pinched as thick as honeycomb. Each pinch more stinging than the bees that meet them.
This island's mine. My sister asks my mother. Which thou takes for me. When thou first came, thou strokest me, and made much of me, was giving me water with berries in it, and teach me how to name the bigger light, and how the less that burn by day and night. And then I love thee, and show thee all the qualities of the isle. Fresh winds, brine pits, barren place, and fertile. Cursed be I that did so, all the charms of cigarettes, toads, beetles, bats, light on you! For I have all the subjects that you had, which first was mine, O king. And this hard rock you do study, whilst you keep me from the rest of the isle.
Thou most lying slave, whom stripes may not move, not kindness. I have used thou filth as thou art, and lodged thee in mine own cell, so thou couldst think to violate the honor of my charge.
Wouldn't have been done. Thou didst prevent me. I had people else this island with caravans.
A bored slave, which any prince of goodness will not take. Being capable of all ill, I pity thee. Took pains to make thee speak, taught thee each hour one thing or other. When thou is not savage, know thy no mean, but would scabble like a thing most brutish, I endowed thy purposes, words made them known, but thy vile grace though thou didst learn, had good things in it that nature could not be but abide to be with. Therefore was thou confined to this rock, who has deserved more than a prison.
You taught me your language, and my prophet on tis, I know how to curse. The red plague greets you for learning me your language.
Accede hence. Fetch us in fuel and be quick. Shruggest thou malice? If thou neglectest, or don't already do what I command, I'll wrap thee with old craps. Fill all thy bones and aches, may be more. The beast shall tremble at thy din.
No, pray thee. I must obey. His art is of such power that it will control my dance god Setibos and make a vassal of him.
Have seen hence.
Again the king my father's back. His music crept by me, upon the waters, and then both their fury and my passion with his sweet air. Thence I followed him, but would have drawn me rather. Watch his gun. The ditty does remember my downfall. This is no mortal business, nor no sound that the earth holds. And hear it now above me again.
The fringe curtains of thine eyes pass. And say what thou seest, young.
What is it? A spirit? Lord, how it looks about. Believe me, sir, it carries a great form. It is a spirit.
No, witch. It eats and sleeps, and has such senses as we have such. This gallant which thou seest was on the rack, but is something stained with grief. That's beauty's canker. Thou mightest call him a goodly person. He hath lost these fellows, and strange about to find them.
I might call him a thing divine, but nothing natural I ever saw so noble.
It goes on, I see, as my soul prompts it. Spirit, thank spirit. I set thee free within 2 days for this.
Most sure the goddess of you will attend. Vouchsafe my permanent if you remain upon this island. You will some for destruction give hand and bear me here. Prime request which has lost Nazis. If you wonder, if you be made or no.
No wonder, sir, but certainly a maid.
Language, heavens, I'm the best in that speak of speech. Where about words is spoken?
How? The best? What word thou if the King of Naples heard thee?
Single thing, as I am now. That wonders to hear thee speak of Naples. He does hear me, and that he does as he weep. Myself from Naples, with my own eyes, never since I then beheld the king my father's wreck.
The lack of mercy.
His faith, and all his lords, the Duke of Milan and his brave son being claimed.
The Duke of Milan and his more braver daughter could control thee, if it were not fit to do it. At first sight, they have changed eyes, delicate Aaron. I'll set thee free for this. A word, good sir, a word. I fear you have done yourself some wrong. A word.
Why speaks my father so ungently? This is the first man, third man that ever I saw. The first that ever I sighed for. Pity me, my father, to be inclined my way.
Oh, if a virgin and your affection not gone forth, I'll make you Queen of Naples.
Soft, sir. One word more. They are both in Nibus powers. But this swift business must I and easy make. Less too light win and make the prize light. One word more. I charge thee that thou attend me. Thou dost hear usurp the name thou owest not, and hast put thyself upon this island as a spy to win it from me, the lord of it.
No, as I am a man.
There's nothing ill can dwell in such a temple. If the ill spirit hath so fair a house, then good things will strive to dwell with it.
Come. Follow, speak not to him. He's a traitor. I'll manacle thy neck and feet together. Sea water shalt thou drink. Thy food shall be the fresh brook mussels, with its roots and husks, wherein the ache uncradled. Follow.
No, I shall resist entertainment till my enemy has more power.
Oh dear father, make not too rash a trial of him. These gentlemen are not fearful.
What? I say my foot to my tutor. Put thy sword up, traitor. Who makest to show what there is but strike? Thy conscience is so possessed with guilt. Come from thy ward. I could hear the song thee with this stick, and make thy weapon drum.
Beseech you, father.
Head, tongue not on my garment.
Sir, have pity. I'll be his surety.
Silence! One word more, shall me be chide thee, if not hate thee. What an advocate for an impostor? Hush! Thou thinkest there is no such shapes as he. Having seen but him and Caliban, foolish wench. To the most of men, this is a Caliban, and they to him are angels.
My affections then may be humbled, and I have no ambition to be a goodly man.
Come on, obey. Thy nerves are in their infancy again, and have no vigour in them.
So they are. My spirits is in a dream of all bound up. My father's lost. The weakness which I feel, nor this man's threat to whom I am subdued, are but light to me. Might I but free my prison once they behold this maid, all corners else of the earth that liberty make use of. Space enough have I in such a prison.
It works. Thou hast done well, fine Ariel. Follow me, and hark what thou else shalt do me.
Be of comfort, sir. My father is of a better nature than he appears by speech. This is unwanted which now came from him.
Thou shalt be as free as mountain winds, but then do exactly all points of my command.
To the syllable.
Come, follow. Speak not for him.
Do you know?
Will you cry out with me, the Ferdinand has drowned?
He's gone.
Then tell me, who is the next heir of Naples?
Clara.
She is the queen of truth. She is the dwarf Tandy, your man's wife.
Oh no.
Stay, Mr. Death, and now see them. Why, they are no worse than now they are. There be that queen of Naples, as well as he that sleeps. Oh, that you bore the man that I do. What sleep this would be for your affairs. Do you understand me?
Sleep thing, I do.
And how does your concept tend to your own good fortune?
I never used to plant your brother Prospero.
True. And look how well my garments sit upon me. Much fitter than before. My brother, sir, would say my fellows. Now, they are my men.
But for your conscience.
Ah, sir, when I said, if to work hard, would put me to my slipper. But I feel not that thy tis my bosom. Oh, no! 20 consciences stand twixt me and Milan. Can be desired, and melt there and less. Here lies your brother, no better than earth and life form. And he's there, and I, with his obedient steel, 3 inches up, can lay to bed forever.
Thy case, dear friend, shall be my present.
Amen.
As though God's Milan, I come by name. Draw thy sword. One stroke shall free thee from the tribute of that past. And our king shall live.
Together. And when I free my hand, do you like to put it upon Gonzalo?
Oh, but one word.
Wherefore this ghastly looking?
What's the matter?
Whilst we stood insecure in your post, even now we heard it all better by fools or lightness.
Did not wake you? It struck my ear most terribly.
I heard nothing.
Oh! To the depth of brown ear! To make an earthquake!
Sure!
It was the roar of a whole herd!
Of lightness. Heard you this, Gonzalo?
Why, my honest son heard, huh? And that strange one, too? But she didn't wake me. I shake you said, quiet in my mouth. It was not a dream. That's better. Lest we stand upon our guard or quit this place. Let's draw weapons.
Lead off this ground. Let's make further search for my poor son.
Cats, people want me to be put here, surely I have.
Lead away!
My lord Prospero shall know what I have done. So, King, go safely to see thy son.
Sometimes
am I all wound up with adders, whose cloven tongues do hiss me into madness? No, now, no! Here comes a stranger this, and to torment me for bringing wood in slowly! I'll fall back, perchance he will not mind me.
Clear is neither bush nor shrub that bear any weather at all. And there's a storm brewing. I hear it in the wind. Yon same black cloud, yon huge one. Looks like a foul bombard that should shed its liquor. If it should thunder as it did before, I know not where to hide my head. Yon same black cloud cannot choose but to fall by the pale foot. What have we here?
A man with fish.
A fish. He smells like a fish. A very ancient and fish-like smell. A kind of, not of the nearest Port John. Strange fish. Where I am in England now, as I once was, and had brought this fish painted, and on a holiday fool they would give but a piece of silver. There would this monster make a man. Any strange beast there makes a man. When they will not give a doit to relieve a lame beggar, they will lay out 10 to see a dead Indian. Ah, leg like a man. Fin like arms. Warm on my troth. I do now let loose my opinion. Hold it no longer. For this is no fish, but an islander that has lately suffered from a thunderbolt. My only way is to creep on this gabardine, but there is no other shelter hereabout. Misery acquaints a man of strange bedfellows, but I shall now hear shrouds of the dregs of the stormy past.
I shall no more to see, to see. Here shall I die ashore. This is a very scary tune to sing at a man's funeral. But here's my comfort. The master, the swabber, the boatswain, and I, the gunner, and his mate, loved Mary and Marjorie, pulled her a pearl, but none of us cared for Kate. This too is a very scary tune, but here's my comfort.
Do not torment me!
What's the matter? Have we devils here? Do you put tricks upon us with savages and menomins? Ha! I have not escaped drowning now to be afeard of your four legs. For it hath been said, as proper as a man as ever went on four legs cannot make him give ground. And it shall be said so again, while Stefano breathes at nostrils.
The spirit torments me!
This is some monster of the Isles, with four legs, who have got, as I take it, an egg. But where the devil should he learn our language? I will give him some relief. If it be but for that, if I can recover him, and keep him tame, I will take too much for him, for he will make a present for any emperor that ever stood on neat's leather.
Do not torment me! Free me! I'll bring my wood home faster.
He's in a fit now, and does not talk after the wisest. I will give him some relief. If it be but for that, if I can recover him and keep him tame, I will take too much for him, for he shall pay for him that hath him, and that soundly.
Thou dost me yet a little hurt, thou alter not, I know it by thy trembling, thou must work upon thee.
Come on your ways, open your mouth, this is that will give language to you, cat. Come, open your mouth, this will shake your shaking, I can tell you that, and that soundly. If you cannot tell who's your friend, come, open your chops again.
I should know it. It should be when he is drowned, and these are devils. Oh, defend me!
Four legs and two voices. A most delicate monster. His forward voice now is to speak well of his friend. His backward voice is to utter foul speeches and retract. If all the wine in my bottle will recover him, I will help you, A. Come, amen. I will pour some in my other mouth.
Stefano,
does my other mouth call me? This is a devil and no monster. I will leave him. I have no long spoon.
Stefano! If thou be Stefano, then touch me and speak to me. By Triculo, be not afraid, thy good friend Triculo.
If thou speak Triculo, come forth, I will call thee by thy lesser legs. If any be Triculo's legs, these be they. How camest thou to be the siege of this moon calf? Does he bend Triculo's?
I took him to be dead with a thunderstroke. But art thou not drowned? At least, I hope thou art not drowned. Has the storm overblown? I hid me under the dead moon calf's gelding for fear of the storm.
But art thou living, Stefano? Oh, Stefano, do thee upon the escape!
Oh, pretty. Do not turn me about, for my stomach is not constant.
These be fine things, and if they be not sprites, that's a brave god, and bear celestial liquor. I will kneel to him.
How didst thou escape? How camest thou hither? Swear by this bottle how thou escaped.
Swim ashore, then, like a duck. I can swim like a duck, I'll be sworn.
Here, kiss the book. Though thou can swim like a duck, thou art made like a goose.
Oh, Stefano, hast any more of this?
The whole what, man? My cellar is a rock by the seaside where my wine is hid. How now, Mooncalf? How does thine ache?
Hast thou not dropped from heaven?
Out of the moon, man, I do assure thee. I was the man in the moon when time was.
I have seen thee in her, and I do adore thee. My mistress showed me thee, and thy dog, and thy bush.
By this lad, this is a very shallow monster. I afraid of him, a very weak monster. The man in the moon. A most credulous monster.
A well-drawn monster in good sooth.
I'll show thee every bird tied into the island, and I will kiss thy foot. I prithee, be my god!
By this lad, this is a perfidious and drunken monster. When God's asleep, he'll rob your bottle.
I'll kiss thy foot. I'll swear myself thy subject.
Come on, then. Down and swear.
I shall laugh myself to death at this puffy-headed monster. A scurvy monster. I can find it in my heart to beat it. But this poor monster's in drink. An abominable monster.
I'll show thee the best springs. I'll pluck thee berries. I'll fish for thee and get thee wood enough. A plague upon the tyrant that I serve! I'll bear him no more sticks! But follow thee, thou wondrous man!
What a ridiculous monster make a poor wonder of the Jonathan.
Prithee, let me bring thee where crabs grow, and I with my long nails shall dig thee pig nuts!
I prithee now lead the way without any more talking. Triculo, the king, and all our company, else being drowned. We inherit here. Here, bear my bottle. I will fill her by and by again.
Farewell, Martha! Farewell! Farewell! No more dams, I'll make full fish. No fetching, firing, and requiring. No spink pinching, no wash dish. Ben, 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 have a new master. Get a new man, free of heartache.
A drunken monster, a howling monster.
Freedom.
lightly and sets off. But this, my mean task, will be as heavy to me as odious. But the mistress which I serve quickens what's dead, and makes slaves pleasures. Oh, she's 10 times more gentle than her father's crab, and he's composed of harshness. I must remove some thousands of these logs and pile them up upon the sore injunction. My mistress weeps when she sees me work.
And that's my prayer, you got not so hard. I would like to have burnt up those logs which you're enjoying to pile. Pray, set it down and rest you, when it's burnt to weep for having wounded you. My father's hard at stone. Pray, rest yourself. He's safe for these 3 hours.
Sweet mistress, the sun will set before I shall strive what I must strive to do.
If you'll sit down, I'll bear your looks well. Pray, give me that, I'll carry it to the fire.
No, precious creature. I'd rather crack my sinews, break my back, than you shall such dishonor and while I sit lazy by.
Well,
to
come
meet
as well as
to come to
you. And I should do it with much more ease, for my preference to it than your business again. You look really.
No, precious creature. It's fresh morning with me and you're bright night. I do beseech you, chiefly because I might set it in my prayers. What is your name?
Miranda. Oh, my father, I
have right
to say so.
Admired Miranda. Indeed the talk of admiration. Worth was dearest to the world. Oh, you, so perfect and so peerless, are created of every creature's best.
I do not know one of my sex. No one's face remember, save from my glass my alone. But I practice something too wildly, my father's precepts by day and do forget. Do you love me?
Oh heavens, oh earth, bear witness to this sound and crown the type of rest with kind event if I speak true. I, beyond all limits else of the world, do love, prize, and honour you.
I am before to weep at what I am revel.
Wherefore weep you?
At my unworthiness, that then offer what I desire to give, much less take that I should die to want. I am your wife if you will marry me, if not, I will die your maid. To be your fellow you may deny me, but I'll be your servant whether you will or no.
And I as humble ever.
My husband then?
Aye, with a heart as willing as ill of bondage freedom. Here's my hands.
And mine, my heart is in. Now, bring around your half an hour.
Half in the thousand.
So glad of this is day I cannot be. Who was surprised by you?
But my rejoicing that nothing can be more.
I tell my book, forget ease of the time, must I perform much business appertaining.
My man wants to have drowned his tongue in sack. Bye, Mom. my standard. Oh, Lieutenant, if you list, he is no Spaniard. We will not run me a steel monster, nor go neither. And yet you lie like gods, and say nothing neither.
Speak once in my life, if I be a good moon car.
How does thy honor? Let me lick thy shoe. I not served him, he's not valiant.
How lies, most ignorant monster? I am in case with just thy of constable. Wilt thou tell a monstrous lie, being half fish and half monster?
Oh, how he mocks me! Wilt thou let him, my lord?
Lord, quoth he, and the monster should be such a natural.
No, no again! Bite him to death, I prithee!
Trinklow, keep a good tongue in your head if you prove a good player.
I thank my noble master. Wilt thou be pleased to hearken to the suit I made to thee?
Marry, I will. Kneel and repeat it. I shall stand. And so shall Trinklow.
As I told thee before, I am subject to a tyrant, a sorcerer, that by his cunning hath cheated me of the island.
Thou liest!
Thou jesting monkey, thou! I would my valiant master would destroy thee, I do not lie!
Trinklow, come into no further danger. Interrupt the monster one word further, and by this hand, I will supplant some of your teeth.
Why? I said nothing.
Mum then, and no more. Proceed.
I say, by sorcery he got this island. From me he got it. If thy greatness will revenge it upon him, for I know thou darest it, but this dark thing dare not.
That's no certain.
Thou shalt be lord of it, and I will serve thee.
How now shall this be compassed? Canst thou bring me to the party?
Yea, my lord. I'll yield him there asleep, where thou mayest knock a nail into his head.
Thou liest. Thou cannot.
What a fine is this, thou scurvy pack? I do beseech thy greatness, give him blows, and take his water from him. When that's done, he shall drink more than brine, so I'll not show him where the expression are.
Trinklow, interrupt the monster one word further, and by this hand, I will throw mercy out of doors and make a stockfish of thee.
Why? What did I? I did nothing. I'll go further off.
Didst thou not say he lied?
Thou liest.
Do I so? Take that! As thou likest, give me the lie another time.
I did not give the lie. Out of your wits and hearing too, a pox of your bottle. This is second drinking too. A merit on your motion, the devil take his fingers.
Stand further off. Forward with your tail.
Beat him enough. After a little time, I'll beat him too.
Stand further off. Proceed.
Why, as I told you before, 'tis a custom with him in the afternoon to see where thou mayest brain him, having first seized his books. Or with a log, batter his skull, or forge him a mistake. His whistle is thy knife. Remember first to possess his books. For without them, he is like the salt as I have, and have not one spirit to command. They all do hate him as beautifully as I. Burn but his books. He has utensils, for so he calls them, which when he has a house, he'll yet reborn. And that most deeply of fear is the beauty.
Is it so brave a lass?
Aye, lord. She will become thy bed, I warrant, and bring thee forth brave brood.
Monster, I will kill this man. His daughter and I will be king and queen. Save our graces. Trinklow and thyself will be viceroys.
thou like the plot to enclose? Excellent.
Come, give me thy hand. I am sorry I beat thee, but while thou livest, keep a good tongue in thy head.
Within this next half hour, bringing me a sleep, wilt thou kill him then?
I, on my honour,
this will I tell my master.
Thou makest me merry. I am full of pleasure. Will thou control the cat you taught me but while here?
At thy request, monster, I will do reason. Any reason. Come, Chirinculo, let us sing. Blout o and scout o and sprout o and scout o and thought is free.
That's not the tune.
Do you know where you're going to? Do you like the thing that life is showing you? Where are you going to? Do you know? Do you care?
I do not have you. Play well, but you'll know what you
mean. If thou should be a man, show thyself in thy true likeness. And if thou should be a devil, take as thou list.
Oh, forgive me my sins. Peace and thine, pay us all debt. Rest be upon us.
Oh, thou afeard?
No, monster. Not I.
Be not afeard. The isle is full of voices, sounds and sweet airs that give delight and hurt not. Sometimes a thousand twanging instruments will come about my ears, and sometimes voices, that then, if I had waked after a long sleep, would make me sleep again. And then in dreaming, the clouds beneath yours would open up and show riches ready to jump upon me. Then when I awoke, I cried to dream again.
This will prove a brave kingdom for me, where I shall have my music for nothing.
When Prospero is destroyed.
That will be by and by. I remember the story.
The sound's going away. Let's follow it after the number.
Lead, monster. And we will follow.
Thank you.
from it, Dick Howry.
I'll be booked. What was else for Christmas? Hunting! And I'm sworn this truth. Travelers never lie. No fools at home could do it.
I cannot do much new. But shape my sketches and must stand
for Christmas.
Behind, for we have fun. Well, please, you take to what is here.
I will stand to her feet. Although my life, no matter, not through the best we pass. Brother, my love, you stand to and do it, please.
Power here to this place, incite them to quick motion.
for I must bestow upon the eyes of this young couple some vanity of mine art. It is my promise, and they expect it from me.
Presently. Two, three, four.
Oh, Tom, the trouble one that made me happy.
assurance that a living prince does now speak to thee. I embrace thy body, and to thee and thy company I bid a hearty welcome.
Whether thou be'st he or no, for some enchanted tribe has sent to abuse me as late I have been, I must know. Thou hope speaks as flesh and blood, and since I saw thee the affliction of my mind amends, to which I fear a madness help. If my craving be at all a most strange story, thou due to my resign, and do in truth thy pardon me of my wrong. How should Prospero be living and be here?
First, noble friend, whose honor cannot be measured or confined, let me embrace thine age.
When you speak of being knacked, I'm knacked
with. She do yet take some subtleties of the eye. Does it not let you believe things certain? Welcome, my friends all. But you, my brace of lords, were I so minded, I here could pluck his highness frown upon you, and justify you traitors. But at this time, I will care no tales.
The devil speaks in him.
No! For you, most wicked sir, whom to call brother would even infect my mouth. I do forgive thy rankest faults, all of them, and require my dukedom of thee, which perforce I know thou must restore.
If thou beest Prospero, give us particulars of thy predilection. How thou was murdered here, when frail the simple wept upon this shore. For I have lost. How sharp the point of this remembrance is, my dear son, Ferdinand.
I am at woe for thee, sir.
Irreparable is the loss. And patient saving past her cure.
I rather think you have not sought her help, of whose soft grace but the light loss, I rest myself content. For I have lost my daughter.
Daughter? Oh heavens, they were living both in Naples. When did you lose your daughter?
In this last tempest. Welcome, sir. This sent my court. Here have I few attendants and subjects none abroad. Pray you, look in. My dukedom, since you have given me again, I will requite you with good a thing. At least content ye as much as my dukedom.
A most high noble!
So you play me false?
No, my sweet mistress, I'm not for the world.
Yes, for a score of wrangles, I should wrangle. And I shall call it fair play.
If this prove a vision of the hour, one dear son shall I twice lose.
Don't see his friends when they're merciful. I've cursed them about cause.
Now all the blessings of a glare, father, compare to your vow. Arise and say how thou camest here.
Oh, the heavens! How many goodly creatures are there here? Oh, brave new world that has such people in it.
Too new to thee.
Who was this maid whom thou wouldst play?
I chose her when I could not ask my father for his advice, nor thought I had one. She is daughter to the famous Duke of Milan, of whom I have so often heard renown, but never seen before. Of him I've received a second life, and a second father, that she may see to me.
I am her. But oh, how odd it is to stand that I must add my own son.
There, sir, stop. Let us not burden our remembrance with the heaviness that son.
Give me your hand. And let grief and sorrow still embrace with her that doth now wish you joy.
And be so amen. Let every man shift from all the rest, and let no man take care for himself, for it is but fortune. Courageo, bully monster. Courageo.
If these be truly spies which I wear on my head, and here's a goodly saying.
Said he was. These be brave spirits indeed. How fine my master is.
I'm afraid he will chastise me.
Uh-huh. What great things are these, my lord Antonio? Full of money, Brian.
Very like. One of them is a plain fish. Blunter.
Mark what the vices of these men, and say if they be true, my lords. This misshapen knave, his mother was a witch. And one so strong that could control the moon, make flows and ebbs,
and did in her command without her power. These free men have robbed me, and this demi-devil, for he is a bastard, one has plotted with them to take my life. Those two fellows you must know and own. This thing of darkness I acknowledge mine.
We shall be pitched in it.
Is this not to follow my drunken butler?
He's drunk now. Where did he find?
And Trinculo is really right. Where should he find this grand liquor that has gilded us? How camest thou in this pickle?
I've been in such a pickle. Since I saw you last, and I will never fare me out of my thoughts. I shall not fear flight blowing.
Why him now, Stefano?
Oh, touch me not. I'm not Stefano, but a crab.
You'd be king of the isle, sirrah.
I should have been a sore one then.
This is a strange thing of air I look upon.
He is of disproportioned in his shape, as in his manners. Go, sirrah, to my cell, and take your companions with you. As you look to have my pardon, show it handsomely.
Aye, that I will. And I'll be wise hereafter, and seek for grace. What a thrice double ass I was, to take this drunkard for a god, and worship this dull fool.
Go to away.
Heads will be stole your luggage where you found it.
Or stole it, rather.
Come. I invite your king and your train to my foresend. And in the morning, I'll bring you to your ship. And so to Naples. Well, I had hoped to see the nuptials of these our dear beloved son of mine, and thence retire me to my Milan, where every bird pool shall be my grave.
I long to hear the story of the life,
which must take the ears friendly.
I'll deliver all, and promise you calm seas, auspicious gales, and sail so expeditious that shall catch a royal fleet far off. My error, chick. That is thy charge. Then to the elements. Be free. And fare thou well.
Now my child, are all off with. What strength I have is mine own. Is most fair. Now it is true, I must be here confined by you, or sent to Naples. Let me not. Since I have my dukedom got and pardoned the deceiver, dwell in this fair island of yours. But release me from my bands with the help of your good hand. Gentle breath of yours, my sense, or else my project fails, which was to please. Now I want spirits to enforce, arms to enchant, and my ending is despair, unless I be relieved by prayer, which pierces so that it assaults mercy itself and frees all. As you from crimes would pardon me, let your indulgence set me free. Yeah.